Welcome to this tutorial of renewable energy resources. In this tutorial we will discuss fuel cell. In the discussion we will include introduction of fuel cell, oxidation and reduction reactions, components of fuel cell, principle of fuel cell and their types. Fuel cell operates on the principle of electrochemistry. Means it converts chemical energy to the electrical energy directly. Fuel cell uses fuel and oxidants and directly convert it to the electrical energy without any combustion. Without any combustion means in the conversion from chemical energy to electrical energy, there is no any intermediate thermal stage. What does it means? If thermal stage is not there in the conversion, the efficiency of this cell is not limited by the Carnot cycle. And when the efficiency is not limited by the Carnot cycle, the efficiency is very high in the fuel cells. Because fuel cell involves oxidation at the anode side and reduction at the cathode side, so it is important to brief you about the oxidation and reduction reactions. So what is the oxidation? Means oxidation, simply one basic definition of the oxidation is it is loss of the electron from the atom. Means in the process of oxidation, electrons are liberated and they becomes free to move. Where in the reduction reaction, atom gains the electron. So simply oxidation is the loss of electron and reduction is the gain of electron, as it is shown in the example. X atom, there is a atom X. This atom releases liberated n number of electrons and becomes positive. For example, hydrogen atom releases 2 electrons and it becomes hydrogen ion. In the same way, in case of reduction, an atom Y receives the electron, gains the n number of electrons and becomes negative ion. For example, oxygen atom gains electrons and becomes oxygen ion. Components of the fuel cell. Fuel cell has 3 basic components, 2 electrodes, and they are separated by an electrolyte. So fuel cell consists of 2 electrochemically conducting electrodes and electrolyte. Generally electrodes are porous. This because pores in the electrode enables better contact between gas, electrolyte and electrodes for the faster electrochemical reaction. So porous nickel is commonly used as electrode. The fuel is fed into anode side of the cell and oxidant is fed into cathode side of the cell. So this is the total construction. Very easy construction. It has only 2 electrodes. And these electrodes are separated by an electrolyte and external load is connected between the anode and cathode. Now, principle of fuel cell. Fuel cell converts chemical energy of a fuel directly into electrical energy. Fuel gas diffuses through anode and it get oxidized. As shown here, the fuel means hydrogen in this case is diffused in the anode where the oxidation takes place. After oxidation, let me pick up the marker. After oxidation, here the hydrogen is converted into H positive ion and it releases 2 electrons. This electron transported through this external circuit to the cathode, whereas the H positive ion moves through this electrolyte and reaches to the cathode. At the cathode side, the H positive ion and oxygen ion combines to form the water. So what is happening at the anode? This hydrogen is converted into H positive ion and releases an electron. This electron travels through the external circuit. After getting its job done, it reaches to the cathode, whereas H positive ion travels through the electrolyte. This is the speciality of this electrolyte. This is where the electrolyte comes into the picture. After the oxidation reaction, when electron is liberated and an ion is produced, this electrolyte does not allow the electrons to travel through the medium. Because of this, electron is bound to travel through the external circuit, whereas it allows ions to travel through it, and ion goes through the electrolyte and reaches to the cathode. And if electrons are traveling to the cathode, if they are not consumed, the excess amount of electrons will increase at the cathode side. Means the electrons will pile up at the cathode, and they will stop the further electrons coming at the cathode. So it is necessary to consume the electrons coming at the cathode side. So for their consumption, oxygen as oxidant is supplied at the cathode side. Here it is shown. Oxygen as an oxidant element is supplied to the cathode side to consume the electrons coming from the anode at the cathode. So to consume the electrons, it is necessary to supply the oxidant, and after the reduction reaction at the cathode side, these electrons are consumed. So if we go to the slide, what it says, the oxidant fuel gas releases electron to the external circuit. The oxidant gas diffuses through cathode, and it is reduced by the electrons coming through the external circuit. The remaining positive ions moves from the anode to cathode through electrolyte, and the negative oxygen ion and positive oxygen ion then combines to form the water. So working is simple. Electrons are hydrogen is coming from this side. It is converted into H positive and releases electron. Electron travels through external circuit because electrolyte does not allow the electron to pass through it, whereas H positive ion travels through this electrolyte and reaches to the cathode. And at the cathode side, reduction reaction takes place, and oxygen and hydrogen combines to form the water, and water is released from here. So electrolyte is important in this system because electrolyte decides the temperature of the cell, the temperature of the operation. How? The electrolyte, different types of electrolytes has different conductivity at different temperatures. Why the conductivity is important here? Because this conductivity of electrolyte decides the rate of transfer of ions through the electrolyte from anode to cathode. means the type of electrolyte. One second, let me pick up the marker. Why the electrolyte is important? Why the electrolyte is important in deciding the temperature of operation? Because as the electron travels from anode to cathode and ions are moving from anode to cathode through the electrolyte, so conductivity of electrolyte is important. Because as the electrons are moving from anode to cathode, the ions should move at the same rate, means the electrons and ions should reach the cathode at the same rate. Because if ion is not moving at the same rate as electron, the electrons will become deposited at the cathode side. Means if the rate of transfer of electron is faster than the ions through the electrolyte, the electrons get deposited at the cathode. So as electron travels from the external circuit, the electrolyte should allow the ion to move at the same rate from the anode to cathode. So the transfer of electron and transfer of ions through the electrolyte should be same for the proper working of the cell. So who will decide the rate of transfer of ions through the electrolyte? It is the conductivity of the electrolyte which is deciding the rate of transfer of ions from anode to the cathode. That's why the electrolyte is important for deciding the types of fuel cell, also the temperature of operation of the fuel cell. At the different temperatures, electrolyte has different conductivity. So this conductivity controls the rate of transfer of the ion through the electrolyte. That's why the electrolyte and temperature consideration is very crucial in the cell. Types of fuel cell. As it is seen in the previous slide, what is important in deciding the type? The choice of electrolyte. The choice of electrolyte is important in deciding the type of the fuel cell. So the type of fuel cell depends on the choice of electrolyte used in it, because electrolyte in the fuel cell is an important component. So the selection of proper electrolyte is very crucial. Selection of electrolyte decides the operating temperature of the fuel cell. On the basis of electrolyte, many different types of fuel cells are available. Some main fuels are listed as: one is polymer electrolyte fuel cell, or it is called proton exchange membrane fuel cell. Other one is alkaline fuel cell, phosphoric acid fuel cell, molten carbonate fuel cell, and solid oxide fuel cells. Many others are there, but these are the main fuel cells. If we go in the detail, we will consider the reactions involved in different types of fuel cells. First, we will consider polymer electrolyte fuel cell or proton exchange membrane fuel cell. In the proton exchange membrane fuel cell, hydrogen is used as the fuel and oxygen is used as the oxidant. This hydrogen is supplied at the anode side and hydrogen is converted into H positive ion and releases two electrons. So what is happening at the anode side? Oxidation reaction takes place where hydrogen is converted into H positive and two electrons are released. As discussed earlier, this electron cannot go through the electrolyte, so it is bound to follow the external circuit, whereas hydrogen ion will go to the cathode through the electrolyte. At the cathode side, this electron will reduce the oxidant and convert it to the oxygen ion, and then this oxygen ion and the hydrogen ion coming through the electrolyte will combine to form the water. Means in this reaction, in this cell, hydrogen ion travels from anode to cathode and electron goes through the external circuit. So there is a movement of hydrogen ion, that's why it is called proton exchange membrane fuel cell. This cell can operate well below the 100 degree centigrade, and in this cell the water generated at the cathode side is a problem. Water management is important in this type of fuel cell. Also, this cell is very susceptible to the impurities. We are supplying the oxygen at the cathode side. Here is anode, here is cathode. We are supplying oxygen at the cathode side. Instead of using oxygen, we may supply air, because air has some amount of oxygen, so air can also be used, but air contains some other gases also, like it contains CO2 and many impurities are also there. So because air has some impurities, it cannot be used preferably oxygen is used. Oxygen is used as an oxidant, air is avoided. So this cell is very susceptible to impurities, and one other characteristic is this cell starts quickly, means after supply the fuel, very quickly it generates the electricity to the external circuit. This other type of fuel cell is alkaline fuel cell. It is shown here the name of metals used at the cathode and anode is mentioned here. Cathode and anode is very expensive in this cell because it is made up of the platinum, whereas name of electrolyte is mentioned because choice of electrolyte is very crucial, as discussed earlier. In the alkaline fuel cell, anode is made up of nickel or silver, whereas cathode may be any metal oxide, and electrolyte used in the alkaline fuel cell is potassium hydroxide. In the alkaline fuel cell, anode is here, cathode is here, anode, this is cathode. OH negative ion from the KOH, OH negative ion travels from cathode to anode. At the anode side, this OH negative ion combines with the hydrogen and forms water, and two electrons are released at the anode. This electron then travels through the external circuit and goes to the cathode. Means transfer of ion in this cell takes place from cathode to anode, and water is formed at the anode side. एंड एट द कैथोड साइड दिस वाटर कंबाइंस विद द ऑक्सीजन एंड आफ्टर रिसीविंग टू इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इट गेट्स रिड्यूस्ड एंड आफ्टर रिडक्शन OH नेगेटिव आयन इज फॉर्म्ड अगेन एट द कैथोड साइड. दिस सेल कैन ऑपरेट वेल फ्रॉम 100 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड टू 250 सेंटीग्रेड एंड दिस इज वेरी रिलायबल बट इट हैंडल CO2 गैस वेरी पुअरली. द नेक्स्ट इज मोल्टन कार्बोनेट फ्यूल सेल. इन द मोल्टन कार्बोनेट एनोड इज मेड अप ऑफ निकल, कैथोड इज मेड अप ऑफ निकल ऑक्साइड एंड इलेक्ट्रोलाइट यूज्ड हियर इज एल्कली कार्बोनेट इन AlO2. लुक एट द रिएक्शन. इन दिस सेल वी कैन यूटिलाइज फॉर द रिडक्शन आइदर हाइड्रोजन और कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड कैन ऑल्सो बी यूज एट द एनोड साइड. इफ हाइड्रोजन इज यूज कार्बोनेट आयन कंबाइंस विद द हाइड्रोजन एट द एनोड बिकॉज इन दिस सेल ऑल्सो आयन मूव्स फ्रॉम कैथोड साइड टू एनोड साइड इन दिस डायरेक्शन. दिस CO3 दिस आयन मूव्स फ्रॉम कैथोड साइड टू एनोड साइड. एट द एनोड इट कंबाइंस विद द हाइड्रोजन एंड कन्वर्ट्स दिस हाइड्रोजन आफ्टर कंबाइनिंग विद हाइड्रोजन इट प्रोड्यूसेस वाटर मॉलिक्यूल CO2 एंड टू इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर लिबरेटेड. दीज इलेक्ट्रॉन्स अगेन विल ट्रेवल थ्रू द एक्सटर्नल सर्किट एंड इफ कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड इज यूज देन दिस आयन कंबाइंस विद द कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड एंड फॉर्म्स CO2 मॉलिक्यूल एंड टू इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. सो वी कैन यूज हाइड्रोजन और कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड एज अ फ्यूल एंड एट द कैथोड साइड दिस कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड जनरेटेड एंड ऑक्सीजन कंबाइंस एंड अगेन प्रोड्यूसेस कार्बोनेट आयन. सो दिस इज द स्पेशलिटी ऑफ दिस सेल. इट कैन यूज वाइड रेंज ऑफ फ्यूल्स एंड कैन ऑपरेट फ्रॉम द 600 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड टू द 700 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड. कैन विथस्टैंड हाई टेम्परेचर बट इट हैज डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ द कोरोजन एंड द थर्मल फटीग. द लास्ट वन इज सॉलिड ऑक्साइड फ्यूल सेल. इन द सॉलिड ऑक्साइड फ्यूल सेल एनोड मटेरियल ऑफ एनोड एंड कैथोड इज मेंशनड हियर. एनोड कैन बी मेड अप ऑफ CO/ZrO2 Ni/ZrO2 एंड कैथोड कैन बी मेड अप ऑफ यूजिंग दिस लैंथेनम मैग्नाइट एंड इलेक्ट्रोलाइट इज Y2O3 स्टेबलाइज ZrO2. इन द सेम वे लाइक द प्रीवियस द इट कैन यूज कैन ऑपरेट विथ अ वाइड रेंज ऑफ फ्यूल्स एज यू कैन सी इन द रिएक्शन. एज अ फ्यूल वी कैन यूज हाइड्रोजन और ऑल्सो वी कैन यूज कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड. दिस हाइड्रोजन इन दिस सेल ऑल्सो द आयन ट्रेवल्स फ्रॉम कैथोड टू एनोड साइड. दिस आयन ट्रेवल्स फ्रॉम एनोड टू कैथोड साइड एंड फॉर्म्स आफ्टर व्हेन आयन मूव्स थ्रू द एनोड द हाइड्रोजन गेट्स ऑक्सीडाइज्ड एंड इट इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू H2O and releases 2 electron. If it is carbon monoxide used as the fuel, then this carbon monoxide will produce CO2 gas and release 2 electron. And at the cathode side, these 2 electrons combined with the oxygen gets reduced, and this oxygen will form O2 negative, means oxygen ion. This is the total working of the fuel cell and their types. So working is easy. Fuel cell basically uses what? 2 electrodes, and these electrodes are separated by the electrolyte. Fuel is supplied at the anode side. This fuel gets oxidized and releases ions and electrons. Ion travels through the electrolyte, whereas electrons travel through the external circuit. And at the cathode side, oxygen is used as the oxidizing element. After traveling through the external circuit, electron arrives at the cathode and it reduces the oxidant, and in many cases it forms H2O, water molecule, at the cathode side. This is all about the fuel cells. Thank you.